Good afternoon. Let me start today's lecture session with the capacitance. Okay. Let us consider two conductors embedded in a homogeneous dielectric medium. Let us consider these two conductors, that is M1, which is negatively charged conductor, and this is M2 conductor, which is positively charged, which is present in a dielectric medium with the permittivity equal to epsilon. So here, since the M2 carries positive charge, the electric flux will be directed from M2 to M1, where M2, let us consider, it is at more positive potential. Let the potential difference between M2 and M1, let us consider it as V0. Hence, the capacitance C can be written as Q divided by V0, okay, where Q is the charge on any one conductor and V0 is the potential difference between the two conductors, where this capacitance is nothing but the ratio of the total charge to the potential difference between the two conductors, okay, where this capacitance can also be expressed as surface integral epsilon into E dot ds vector. This whole thing gives the capacitance, sorry, the charge, and this whole thing gives the capacitance charge, and it divided by integral E dot dl, this gives the potential difference. Okay, so this ratio, in fact, it results in the capacitance, which is nothing but charge divided by the potential. Okay, let us try to find out the capacitance between two parallel plate conductors. Okay, so what can be seen in this figure is there are two parallel plates. One is positively charged conductor and the second one is negatively charged conductor. And between the potential difference applied between these two conductors, let us consider it as V0. And these two capacitors, the field intensity will be directed, what is shown here, it will be electric field intensity will be directed from positive charge conductor to the negative charged conductor. And the permittivity present in this medium, that is, let us consider it as epsilon, okay. And the one of the parallel plate conductor, which is at z equal to 0, and one more conductor, it is at z equal to d distance, okay. And we'll assume the field intensity will be directed in the positive z direction, okay. And these two conductors are separated by a distance d in the z direction. So hence, the electric field intensity can be expressed as the surface charge density out of any two conductors divided by the permittivity in the medium. So where multiplied by az cap, because electric field intensity will be in the z direction. So electric field intensity E vector can be written as surface charge density divided by epsilon into az cap. Where epsilon is nothing but the permittivity of this homogeneous dielectric medium. So once we get electric field intensity, easily we can find out the electric flux density. So where the electric flux density D vector will be equal to surface charge density rho s multiplied by unit vector az cap. That is, this electric field intensity epsilon into E vector is nothing but D vector. Hence, using this equation, D vector will be nothing but rho s, this one, multiplied by, it is in the unit vector az cap direction. Where the potential difference between the two plates, that is lower and upper plates, can be written as V0 equal to minus integral from upper plate to lower plate E dot dl vector, which is equal to minus, what is electric field intensity? It is here, okay. That can be substituted here, multiplied by, this should be integrated with respect to z, okay. So this is a line integral. So in integration, this is a constant now. So dz integration is nothing but z. So and the, if you apply the limits, we get the answer as potential difference is equal to rho s by epsilon into d, where q is the we can find out the charge q, which is nothing but surface charge density multiplied by the surface area. Let us consider the surface area S. Hence, the charge q on any one conductor will be nothing but surface charge density rho s multiplied by the surface area S. S is the area of the plane. So hence, the potential difference V naught will be equal to the surface charge density rho s by epsilon into d, where d is the separation between the two plates. Hence, what is capacitance? Capacitance C is nothing but charge q divided by V naught. Okay. Hence, the charge q is nothing but rho s into s, and V naught is nothing but rho into d by epsilon. This rho and this rho will get cancelled. Hence, the capacitance will become epsilon into s divided by d. Okay. So this is the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor. Okay. So now you have to remember, the capacitance of parallel plate capacitor can be expressed as epsilon is the permittivity in the medium, and S is nothing but the surface area of the conductor divided by D, where D is the separation between the two parallel plates of the two conductors. Hence, the capacitance of the two parallel plate capacitor is nothing but epsilon S divided by D. We'll try to find out what is the energy stored once we get the capacitance or the electric field intensity. We'll try to find out what is the energy stored in this system. Okay. So where energy stored can be written as half into volume integral epsilon E square into differential volume. Okay. Where E is the, this capital E is nothing but electric field intensity. So this differential volume can be written as differential surface area multiplied by the differential length. So since here the field intensity is in z direction, so let us write this differential volume as the differential length, that is dz, multiplied by the differential surface area. So we are splitting the volume into surface integral multiplied by the length. So surface integral is nothing but 0 to s, and the length is nothing but 0 to d. Hence, the energy stored will be equal to half into rho s square by epsilon into s into d. So that is the integration of this ds is nothing but s, integration of this dz is nothing but d. Okay. So and here, what is electric field intensity? We have seen here electric field intensity is nothing but rho s by epsilon. Okay. By substituting that here, electric field intensity is nothing but rho s by epsilon whole square. One epsilon on one epsilon will get cancelled. So remaining thing is half into rho s square by epsilon, and integration of this ds is nothing but s, and integration of dz, and by substituting the limit, it is nothing but d. Okay. Hence, it will be equal to half into epsilon s by d. What we are trying to do here is, let us multiply by, we have here s into d. Okay. So what we'll do here is, again we'll try to multiply by epsilon by d. Okay. So we'll multiply and divide by epsilon by d, that is epsilon into d divided by epsilon into d. Okay. So further, this equation can be modified in this way. Okay. Where, why we are trying to do here like this is, what is epsilon s by d? We have seen in the previous equation, epsilon into s by d can be written as capacitance. Okay. And potential V naught can be written as rho s d by epsilon. Okay. Using this V naught and capacitance expressions, we can write this equation can be modified as half into, this is nothing but capacitance, this whole thing is nothing but V square. So this can be expressed as half into CV square. And since we have a relation between capacitance and the charge and the potential, so half into CV square can also be expressed as half into Q V naught, or it is also can be written as half into Q square by C, so much of joules. Okay, this is the energy stored in the parallel plate capacitor. Further, we'll try to take one problem. The problem goes like this. It is calculate the capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor having a mica dielectric with relative permittivity equal to 6, a plate area of 10 inches square and a separation of 0.01 inch, okay, where 1 inch is nothing but 0.0254 centimeter. So here we are trying to convert this one in inches into meter square, okay. So we are converting into the surface area as well as the separation between the two plates, the D and the surface area, both we are converting into meter in the form of standard form. Hence, the capacitance C, we know it is nothing but epsilon S by D. So, epsilon is nothing but epsilon naught multiplied by epsilon R. Epsilon naught value is 8.854 into 10 power minus 12. Epsilon R is nothing but 6. So, by substituting this and the surface area divided by the distance between or the separation between the two conductors D, by substituting this, we get the capacitance C, nothing but in this, with this particular problem, with these data, it is 1.349 nanofarad. So further, we'll try to consider one more problem where we'll try to find out the energy stored. So the question goes like this. Find the relative permittivity of the dielectric material present in a parallel plate capacitor if the first part of the problem is surface area is given, distance between the two conductors is given and the potential is given and the capacitor contains 1 microjoule of energy. Okay, with this data, what is the permittivity? Let us try to find out. Okay, what is energy stored can be written as half into CV square. Okay, or the capacitance can be written as, using this first expression, C can be written as 2 into WE divided by V naught, okay, just cross multiplication, V naught square, sorry, where capacitance is nothing but epsilon S by D. So further, this can be modified as relative permittivity can be written as, it goes like this, just a cross multiplication, D goes to the numerator, S goes to the denominator. So where epsilon is nothing but epsilon naught into epsilon R. So further, epsilon R can be expressed like this, okay. So all the data has been given, surface area is given in the problem, D is given, energy stored and the potential is given. We know what is epsilon naught, 8.854 into 10 power minus 12. Hence, the capacitance or sorry, relative permittivity will be equal to 1.045 numerical value. So further, part B in this problem, the stored energy density is 100 joules per meter cube, potential is 200 volt. And the separation between the two conductors is 45 micrometer. What has to be found here is, it is the relative permittivity. So let us try to find that relative permittivity for this data. So what we are trying to use here is, we can write it as epsilon into D can be written as volume, that is energy stored divided by S into D. Okay. So energy stored divided by S into D can be written as half into CV square divided by S into D. Okay. So here energy stored has been given in the problem. Just substitute. And what is the thing is, we have to find out the relative permittivity. Very simple. All the data has been given, just direct substitution. So because this energy stored is given and the potential difference has been given and the potential difference is given and the distance between the two conductors are given, just direct substitution, which further results in, here S and S will get cancelled, so further results in epsilon R equal to 1.14. Okay. We'll take the part C in this. In the part C, electric field intensity is given and surface charge density is given and the separation between the two conductors has been given. Again, we have to find out the relative permittivity. So where we can use potential difference is nothing but electric field intensity into D, where D is the separation between the two conductors. Hence, the potential difference V naught will be equal to rho S D by epsilon. Okay. which is nothing but E into D. This E is nothing but rho S by epsilon. Okay, so just cross multiplication. So epsilon R will be nothing but rho S divided by electric field into E naught, that is epsilon naught. Okay, so by substituting this rho S value given in the part C question and the electric field intensity, and what we know is epsilon naught permittivity of the free space, by substituting this we get the answer as 11.294. okay, so we have done with this second problem where we are finding the permittivity for this part A or part B and part C. Further, we'll consider one more problem, that is we have found the capacitance of two parallel plate conductors. What was the capacitance of two parallel plate conductor? It is nothing but the capacitance C will be equal to epsilon S by D. Okay, similar to that, let us consider a coaxial cable. Okay, coaxial cable in the sense you will be having a two concentric cylinders. Okay, where let us consider one cylinder, the inner cylinder, let us consider maybe having a radius of A, and let us consider the outer conductor may be having a radius B. Okay, find the capacitance of a coaxial cable of inner radius A and the outer radius B, and length of the conductor is nothing but L. Okay, and with surface charge area, let us consider it as rho S. Okay, using this data, let us try to find out the capacitance of two capacitance of two concentric conductors. Concentric conductor in the sense one will be positively charged and one more conductor will be negatively charged. Okay, so inner one let us consider having a radius small a, and the outer one let us consider having a radius b. Okay, normally we know what is potential difference. Potential difference between these two conductors, VAB, is nothing but it is equal to minus integral A to B E dot dl. Okay, potential difference is nothing but VAB equal to minus integral A to B E dot dl vector. Okay, so, and we know one more thing, the electric flux density can be written as surface charge area rho S. Okay, multiplied by in which direction there is a flux density divided by the radius rho. Okay, so where first let us try to find out what is the potential difference between the these two conductors. So VAB can be written as minus integral B to A. So B is the radius of the outer conductor and A is the radius of the inner conductor, so which will be equal to rho S into A divided by epsilon. Okay, this we are trying to find out what is electric field intensity, so it is rho S by epsilon. Okay, in multiplied by differential surface area. Okay, so by integrating this, so we have it is nothing but this, it is nothing but 1 by rho. Okay, so 1 by rho integration is nothing but log rho, and by substituting the limits it will become log B by A. Okay, hence once we get the potential difference, we can find out automatically what is capacitance. So capacitance is nothing but charge Q divided by potential V naught. Okay, so what is charge Q here? Charge Q is nothing but surface charge density rho S multiplied by the surface area. So what is surface area? Can be considered as 2 pi into L multiplied by the radius of the inner or the outer conductor. Okay, so let us consider at radius of A, so it will become 2 pi epsilon L into A divided by this. Okay, divided by this, and that A and A will get cancelled, so capacitance C will be equal to 2 pi epsilon L divided by log B by A. Okay, so the electric flux density is rho S A by rho. So we are trying to integrate this 1 by rho. 1 by rho will result in log rho, and substituting the limits and then writing capacitance is equal to C equal to Q divided by V, we are getting this answer. Okay, hence now we can try to remember this, the capacitance of coaxial cable, the second capacitance in this particular heading, that is capacitance of coaxial cable, will be equal to 2 pi epsilon L divided by log P by A. So there are two things now. One is capacitance of parallel plate conductor, and the second one is capacitance of coaxial cable. Okay, so where coaxial cable capacitance is 2 pi epsilon L divided by log B by A. We'll try to consider one more problem, that is find capacitance of spherical capacitor formed by two concentric spherical conducting shells of radius A and B, where B is greater than A. Okay, so what we have tried here is, one is trying to find the capacitance of two parallel plates, and second one is capacitance of two cylinders. Okay, and third problem here is, now there are two conductors which are in the spherical shapes. Okay, there are two concentric conductors which are in spherical shape. Okay, for this we have to find out what is the capacitance for this spherical capacitor. Okay, then we'll take this part B and C. What is the capacitance? To find that, we'll try to find out what is the electric field intensity due to this charge conductor. Okay, so where electric field intensity can be written as, suppose let us assume the charge on the conductor is Q. So the field intensity can be expressed as Q divided by 4 pi epsilon into R square, and the field intensity is in the radial direction. Okay, so field intensity can be written as Q divided by 4 pi epsilon R square into R cap. Okay, so once we get the field intensity, we can find out the potential difference. For potential difference between the two conductors AB, which is nothing but equal to minus integral B to A E dot dl vector, okay, which will be equal to minus integral B to A. So what is field intensity? It is already, we have got here, it is nothing but Q by 4 pi epsilon R square into differential length vector is nothing but dr into AR cap. Okay, AR dot AR is 1, so hence we get only into dr. Okay, so let us integrate this 1 by R square with respect to R. So what is integration of 1 by R square? It is minus 1 by R, which is written here. Hence it becomes, and integration limit is from B to A. Okay, so once we integrate and substitute the limits, we get the answer as Q divided by 4 pi epsilon 1 by A minus 1 by B. So once we get the potential difference, we can find out what is called capacitance. Okay, so what is capacitance? Capacitance C is nothing but Q divided by potential VAB. Okay, hence it will be equal to, we have got here what is called the potential difference, which is nothing but Q by 4 pi epsilon 1 by A minus 1 by B. What is charge Q can be written as? Charge Q can be written as, the whole charge present here, let us write it as Q itself. Okay, this Q and Q you can cancel. Hence it becomes capacitance C will be equal to 4 pi epsilon divided by 1 by A minus 1 by B. Okay, now we have to remember three things. One is the capacitance of two parallel plate conductors, that is C will be equal to epsilon S by D. Okay, second thing is the capacitance of coaxial cable. What was the capacitance of coaxial cable? It is it is equal to 2 pi epsilon L divided by log B by A. Okay, where L is the length of the conductor, B is the radius of the outer conductor, A is the radius of the inner conductor. Okay, this was the capacitance of the second thing, that is coaxial cable. Now the third one, the capacitance of spherical capacitor, which is resulting as C equal to 4 pi epsilon divided by 1 by A minus 1 by B. Okay, where A is the radius of the inner conductor, inner spherical conductor, and B is the radius of the outer spherical conductor. Okay, further in this problem, we'll take the part B. What is part B? If outer sphere becomes infinitely large, what is the capacitance of an isolated conductor? Okay, that is, the outer sphere, if it is lying at a infinitely large distance, what is the capacitance of this isolated capacitor? We have to find out. So how to go about this problem? Okay, since the outer conductor, that is this B, is there at the infinity, in this expression let us substitute this B as infinity, so it becomes 1 by infinity. So capacitance of isolated capacitor will become only results in C equal to 4 pi epsilon A. This is part B. Now what is part C in this? Find the capacitance of the above isolated capacitor if it has the following dielectric coating, where epsilon equal to epsilon 1 from R equal to A to R equal to R1. Okay. Over a distance, suppose this dielectric coating, if it is equal to epsilon 1 from radius A equal to R1, if it is permittivity epsilon 1, what is the capacitance we have to find out? So we'll take this part C. So part C is nothing but the flux density D is nothing but Q divided by 4 pi R square. Okay, where electric field intensity will be equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon 1 R square. Why epsilon 1? In the distance R between radius R between A to R1, it is field the permittivity is epsilon 1. Hence electric field intensity becomes Q divided by 4 pi epsilon 1 R square. Okay, R, the same thing will be equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R square if radius R, if it is greater than R1. Okay, because only in the distance A to R1 there is a coating of epsilon 1, otherwise from R1 to infinity let us consider it as epsilon naught. Okay, so the potential difference VA minus V infinity will be equal to minus integral R1 to A Q divided by 4 pi epsilon 1 R square into dr minus integral from infinity to R1. Okay, we are trying to find out this VA minus V infinity. One is from integrating this one, this field from R1 to A and then from infinity to R1. Okay, so by doing this we are getting it as charge Q divided by 4 pi into this. Okay, hence the capacitance C will be equal to 4 pi divided by this, because it is nothing but Q divided by V. So V is so much, this Q and Q will get cancelled, so capacitance C will be resulting in this. Okay, so this is slightly complicated, wherein we are trying to find out the capacitance with the within the separation of the two conductors, there may be a different dielectric constant. Okay, so over the medium the dielectric constant may be varying, so for that we are trying to consider part of the distance it is epsilon 1 and part of the distance it is epsilon naught. So using that we are getting the capacitance in this particular problem with the given data, it is equal to 4 pi divided by so much. Further, we'll consider one more problem, that is find the capacitance of the following parallel plate capacitor. Okay, so what has been done in this parallel plate capacitor is again something similar to the previous problem. Here it is actually the capacitance, it is the dielectric medium, it is divided into two things. One is over a distance of d1 it is epsilon 1, over a distance of d2 it is epsilon 2. Okay, so on the surface area is S. For this dielectric distribution, we have to find out the capacitance. Okay, so what is capacitance here? We can consider these two capacitors are connected in series. Okay, so where capacitance from for one capacitor for one this medium, we can write C1 equal to epsilon 1 into S by D1, and further C2 is nothing but epsilon 2 into S by D2. Okay, where these two, the capacitance of this part and the capacitance of this one, they are in series. Hence the equivalent capacitor is nothing but, as we know, it is equal, 1 by C equivalent is equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2. Hence the C equivalent is nothing but 1 divided by 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2. Hence, it will be equal to 1 divided by this, will be resulting in d1 by epsilon 1 s plus d2 by epsilon 2 s. Okay. So, what has to be focused in this problem is the capacitors are taken R into, they are considered as they are in the series. Okay. For this, we are trying to find out what is the capacitance. Okay. R, one more way of solving this is the potential V naught, the total potential difference between these two is nothing but it is can be written as E1 into D1 plus E2 into D2, where E1 is the field intensity in the first part and E2 is the field intensity in the above part. Okay. At the dielectric interface, we know from the properties of the conductor, okay, and the properties of the dielectric medium. At the dielectric interface, electric field intensity is normal, okay. So, where dn1 can be written as dn2, or epsilon1 into E1 will be equal to epsilon2 into E2. So, potential V0 can be written as, this is written as it is, plus E2. What is E2 can be written in terms of E1? It is E1 into epsilon1 by epsilon2, further multiplied by this D2 here, okay. So, this is V0. So, what is field intensity from this V0? E1 can be written by using this expression in this manner, okay. So, at the conductor interface, we can take the boundary condition of the conductor, okay. So, where is the flux density is nothing but the surface charge density, that is one of the boundary condition of the conductor, okay. So, where the surface charge density rho s1 can be written as epsilon1 into E1. So, we have got what is E1 here, just a substitution here. So, rho s1 is nothing but V0 divided by this. Hence, what is capacitance? C is nothing but Q divided by V0, okay. So, it will be equal to, what is Q? Q is nothing but surface charge density rho s multiplied by the surface area. So, it is nothing but C will be equal to this Q divided by, just now we have got what is V0, okay. We substitute that, so hence capacitance will result as 1 divided by this, okay. This also tells the equivalent capacitance is nothing but 1 divided by 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2, okay. Further, what we can understand from this is these two capacitors which are connected in, one capacitor here, one capacitor here, they are connected in series. So, let us try to find out one more problem. Let us consider, that is, find the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor for the given figure. Okay. So, what has been done here is, in the previous problem, the dielectric interface has been divided horizontally. Okay. For part of the horizontal over the interface, it is epsilon 1. Part of horizontal interface, it is epsilon 2. Okay. But further here, the dielectric interface, it is divided vertically, okay. Part of this vertical division, it is epsilon 1, okay, over a same separation of D, and over the same separation D, part of it is epsilon 2, okay. So, instead of dividing the permittivity horizontally, now the permittivity is divided into vertically. So, part of it vertical division, it is epsilon 1, and part of it is epsilon 2, okay. What can be assumed here is, you have two capacitors. One is having epsilon 1 permittivity between the conductors. One is having the epsilon 2. Okay. It is connected in this manner. This plate and this plate are connected. And these two down plates are connected in this manner. Hence, what can be assumed is, these two capacitors are parallelly connected. Okay. That means, what answer are we expecting here? The equivalent capacitance should be equal to C1 plus C2. Okay. We'll see, are we going to get using the boundary condition of the dielectric interface and also by considering the boundary condition of the conductor. So, it goes like this. The potential difference V0 is nothing but E1 into D. It must be same as E2 into D. Okay. Because the separation between the conductor, it is same thing D. So, it is either the field intensity E1D or it is E2 into D. Okay. So, hence, as we know, at the interface, okay, at the interface, the tangential fields at the interface can be written as d1 by epsilon 1 must be equal to d2 into epsilon 2, okay, which is nothing but potential V0 divided by d. Where we know the total surface charge density can be written as rho s equal to rho s1 plus rho s2, okay. From this, the total charge Q is nothing but this rho s1 into s1 plus this rho s2 into s2, which can be written as, this can be written as V0 by D into epsilon 1, okay. This rho s can be written in this way multiplied by s1, and this rho s2 can be written as V0 into epsilon 2 divided by D, okay. Where capacitance C is nothing but charge Q divided by V0, okay. If by taking this and dividing by V0, we get it as rho s1 into epsilon, s1 plus rho s2 into s2 divided by V0, okay. Or this can be written as capacitance C is nothing but epsilon 1 into s1 plus epsilon 2 into s2 divided by D, okay. Because we know what is potential. Potential is nothing but, we have in the previous equation, potential is nothing but E1 into D, or it is also nothing but E2 into D. Okay? By substituting that, we get it as capacitance C will be equal to epsilon 1 S1 by D plus epsilon 2 S2 by D, which is nothing but C1 plus C2. Hence, we can say, as I said earlier, that these two capacitors will look like they are in parallel, okay. So upper, two upper plates are connected and two lower plates are connected. So where we can consider these two capacitors are in parallel. Hence the equivalent capacitance is nothing but C1 plus C2. Okay. Further we'll consider one more problem, that is the capacitance, find the capacitance of a conducting sphere of 2 cm in diameter covered with a layer of polyethylene with epsilon r equal to 2.26 and 3 cm thickness, okay. So this is the data given, so and also the figure has been given here. The diameter of this conducting sphere is 2 cm and the permittivity it is 2.26, okay, and the thickness here it is 3 cm. That means outer one is having with the, if you consider the radius as 1 cm, the outer one radius will be 1 plus 3, which is nothing but 4 cm. Okay. So inner radius is 1 cm, outer conductor radius is 4 cm. Okay. So using this, we have to find out the capacitance. It is very much straightforward. The capacitance is nothing but 4 pi epsilon 1 by A minus 1 by B. Okay. So what is epsilon? It is nothing but permittivity epsilon naught into this relative permittivity. So that has been substituted here. Relative permittivity of 2.26 into epsilon naught. Okay. Divided by 1 by A. A is nothing but it is 1 centimeter radius. And B is nothing but radius of 4 centimeter. By substituting that, the capacitance here, the answer is 3.35 picofarad. Okay, it is very much straightforward. Suppose further, if you consider the second sphere is isolated, okay, then it can be written as 4 pi epsilon r1. Okay, for this, the capacitance, further capacitance for isolated sphere can be written as 4 pi epsilon into R1, okay, which will be giving as 4.45 picofarad, okay. Further, if these two are considered as in series, then the equivalent capacitor can be written as 1 by 1 divided by 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2, okay. So, if it is asked for finding the isolated capacitor, further the equivalent capacitor will result in this manner. Let me consider one more problem, that is a parallel capacitor, plate capacitor with a separation of 1 centimeter, it is given here, as applied with a 29 kilovolts when air was the dielectric used. Assume further the dielectric strength of air as 30 kilovolt per centimeter. A thin piece of glass with epsilon r equal to 6.5 with a dielectric strength of 290 kilovolt per centimeter has been applied. Okay, with thickness of 0.2 centimeter is inserted further. It has been inserted here. Okay, find whether the glass will break or air. Okay, so we'll try to find out here. There are two capacitors formed here. Okay, because of this arrangement. Okay. The air capacitor is nothing but epsilon naught into A divided by D1. Okay. So, what is A? A is nothing but the surface area. So, it is whatever the epsilon naught multiplied by area divided by this. So, capacitance in air is so much into area A, so much of farad. So, it is 1.1 into 10 power minus 9 into area A, that much of farad. What is the capacitance of the glass can be found as epsilon naught into epsilon r into area A divided by distance d2. Okay, what is d2 here? It is 0.2 centimeter. So further, the capacitance C2 will be calculated in this manner. So it gives the answer as the direct substitution with the numerical value calculation. It becomes 2.87 into 10 power minus 8 area A. So much of farad. Okay, where as we can see here, these two capacitors are connected in series. Okay, hence the equivalent capacitance is nothing but it will be 1 divided by 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2. Hence it becomes equivalent to C air into C glass divided by air plus glass. So further it results the by using these two values, it becomes 1.0657 into 10 power minus 9 into area A, so much of farads. Okay. Let the area of cross section, let us assume it equal to 1 meter square, which has been not mentioned in the problem. So we'll consider it as 1 meter square. Okay. Hence, the equivalent capacitance will be equal to this, so much of farads. The same thing multiplied by A equal to 1 meter square. So, which results in 1.06 into 10 power minus 9 farads. Okay. And the total charge Q will be equal to C equivalent into potential. Okay. Potential has been given as 29 kilovolt, which will result as Q equal to this. Okay. Hence, the potential of air can be written as Q divided by C in the air. Okay. The capacitance in the air. Hence, this will become 3.09 into 10 power minus 9 10 power minus 5 divided by this. Okay, so potential difference in the air will be nothing but 27.9 kilovolt. Further, let me consider for the today's session one more last problem. Let me consider here, that is the width of the region containing epsilon r1 in the figure is 1.2 meter. Find epsilon r1 if epsilon r2 is given as 2.5 and the total capacitance is 60 nanofarad. Okay, so what has been given here is what one thing has to be observed here is the permittivity is divided into vertically. That means here the capacitors are connected in parallel. They are connected in parallel. Okay, so one of them part of it is having epsilon r1. One more capacitor is having the permittivity epsilon R2. Okay. And they are having separated by these two conductors separated by a distance 2 mm. Okay. And the total length of this is 2 meter. And here the total length is 2 meter. And one of that having permittivity epsilon R1 is having a width of 1.2 meter. And this permittivity is having a width of 0.8 meters. Okay. Using this data, we have to consider this problem of a parallel plate capacitor to find out permittivity epsilon r1. Okay, where we know distance separation of this d is nothing but 2 mm. Okay, let us consider what is the area of the first capacitor, that is a1. Okay, what is a1? A1 is nothing but this one. Okay, it is equal to 2 meter multiplied by 1.2 meter. Okay. So, A1 is 2 meter into 1.2. So, it becomes 2.4 meter square. Similarly, what is A2? A2 is nothing but this distance, same 2 meter, but this width is 0.8 meter. So, it becomes 2 into 0.8. So A2 is 2 into 0.8. So by using this, we get A1 and A2. Further, capacitance C1 for a parallel plate, we know it is epsilon A by D. So direct substitution, we get here, but we don't know what is epsilon R1. We'll let us retain as it is. So we get with these numerical values, we get this straightforward calculation, so much of farad. C2, all the data is given, epsilon R2 is also there. A2 has been calculated. By substituting this, we get so much, 1.7 into 10 power minus 8 farad. So since these two capacitors are connected parallelly, so equivalent capacitance can be written as C1 plus C2. Okay. Hence, it will be equal to this value, 1.6 into epsilon R1 plus 1.7 into 10 power minus 8. Okay. By adding this and equating that to 60 nanofarad, and we can find out epsilon R1 equal to 3.98 farad. Okay. So this is almost straightforward. Only thing is, one thing has to be understood here is the capacitors are connected parallelly and they are given equivalent capacitance. Only thing is, we have to find out the relative permittivity of the first parallel plate capacitor, that is, which are separated by a distance of 2 mm. So this epsilon R1 we are trying to, so which is resulting as 3.98 farad. Okay. Further, we'll try to consider more problem in next lectures in the repetition class. Okay. Let me stop here. Okay. Thank you.